was buried alive, but I'm still breathing. I don't know what tomorrow may bring, but I got a feeling. I am alive, there must be a reason. I was given one more chance, my heart's still beating.
Let God lead you out, don't let the devil kick you out.
Hey guys, so quick word for you, you know, let God lead you out, don't let the enemy kick you out, okay? Let God lead you out, do not let the enemy kick you out. And what that means is, you know, you guys may be in companies right now, in environments, in neighborhoods where you know that 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 God has you there for a reason, okay? He called you to be there. He positioned you there, okay? You need to understand that the enemy is not going to allow you to just take over territory without a fight, all right? You guys need to understand that you are the light and you're the salt of the earth, right? And darkness don't like light. So when you roll up in that neighborhood, when you roll up in that company, you know, taking over that leadership position or whatever it is that God has called you to be, you need to understand that you are making people feel very uncomfortable. Darkness does not feel comfortable in the presence of light. Let me say that again. Darkness does not feel comfortable in the presence of light. So you need to understand that you're making people feel very uncomfortable. So because you make them feel uncomfortable, they're going to make you feel uncomfortable as well. So, and they're going to try to do whatever it is possible to get you to leave. All right. Once you know that God has you there for a reason, you need to stand your ground. You need to stand your ground. No matter what tactics come your way, you need to stand your ground, because there's a reason for you to be there. There's lessons to be learned. There's changes to be made, all right? And on both your end, okay, there's character building that's taking place. You know, so you're there for a reason. So stand your ground. Stay where God has placed you, despite what the enemy's trying to do, because you belong there. Okay. And when it's time, allow the Lord to lead you out. Don't let the enemy kick you out before it's time, because you are there for a reason. Okay, guys.
There are three angels named in the Bible: Michael, Gabriel, and Lucifer. Two of them are still in place. One is not. Jesus said one of them fell like lightning. He saw Satan fall like lightning. He had instruments on the inside of him. He could sing better than everybody you know put together. But instead of the worship coming through him, he wanted it to come to him. So God had to kick him out, because nobody can handle worship but the living God. And nobody is worthy of worship but the living God. And the reason why the enemy hates you so much is because you and I get to worship God out of choice.
How to know the voices in your head are God or the demons? Before we start, can you please press the share button and share this to someone, so that they will not end up doing something bad from the voices they're your head. Okay, now let's start. Those voices that are demanding or negative thoughts does are the demons talking to you, so don't trust those voices. And those voices that are positive thoughts or that are good things to do now, that is God talking to you. He is the one that you have to trust, not those demanding and negative thoughts demons. For example, someone in your head tells you to go and kick your mother. That are the demons trying to make you look bad. But if someone in your head tells you that you should probably pray or go to church, that is God. He wants you to come to heaven. Hope this helped you. Now go and pick the right choice.
Exposing the Devil Revealed, Part 2. Lucifer is a fallen angel that got kicked out of heaven due to his excessive pride, vain, ego, and vanity. The devil is also known as Lucifer, which is the original name that God gave to him in heaven. Lucifer was one of the most prettiest angels in heaven. There was a war in heaven. He got kicked out of heaven. Now he's on earth, and he deceived the whole world. The book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 7 through 9 states, "And there was a war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the devil, and the devil and his angels fought back. But he was not strong enough, and they lost their place in heaven. The great dragon was hurled down, that ancient serpent called the devil or Satan, who leads the whole world astray. He was hurled to the earth, and his angels with him." Satan deceived one third of the angels in heaven and got kicked out of heaven with these angels. The devil's time is running short. We are in the last days and end times. The book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 12 states, "Therefore rejoice, you heavens, and you who dwell in them, but woe to the earth and the sea, because the devil has gone down to you. He is filled with fury because he knows that his time is short." The devil clothes himself in propaganda, but Jesus Christ is the truth. The devil camouflages and disguises himself, and he masquerades as an angel of light. The devil's character is unfaithful and a betrayer. The devil uses patterns, deceitfulness, deception, and all lies. The devil can also be known as camouflage, disguise, concealment, mask, veil, masquerade, pretense, blind, facade, false front, imitation, and also superficial, fake, and disguises himself. The devil uses magic, Wicca, witchcraft, spells, and voodoo on people. Beware of your enemy. Be conscious of your enemy. Have awareness of your enemy. And have consciousness of your enemy. Do not play checkers with Satan. Stay focused and serious in Jesus' name.
Okay, so I was driving to Bible study today and I just was crying because I realized how much victory I have over something and how I've been hit with it, like, I think more than 10 times in the last 24 hours, and I'm victoriously walking in it. And I was like, thank God. And he was like, okay, well, you're gonna talk about it now. And I'm like, but I have to really talk about it. So here it is, and I hope this is relatable. So about 6 months ago, I kind of hit this like wall with the Lord, about this thing that he's been asking me to carry and nourish and honor, but I couldn't keep carrying it with this character defect that I have it doesn't help. It made it worse. It made it hard and heavy and hurtful and like painful. And like, I couldn't nourish what the Lord had been asking me to carry, and he wasn't taking that away, but he was like illuminating all this other stuff about me that needed to go. Does that make sense? So basically what happened was, I had a moment where I freaked out and I like flung my arms like this, like cried out to God, and I hit my hand on the wall and I busted my knuckles all up and I got all swollen, and then I cried on the bed and I like basically laid on my bed with my legs against the wall screaming out to God and saying, you have to take this, like I can't carry it anymore. Not carry what God had, like I said, if you can't take this, you got to take this, because I realized that they couldn't go together anymore. And this character defect that I had, like I begged him to burn it off. Can you relate? Do you have moments like that? And then afterwards, you're like, why did I ask you to do this? Why did I pray for you to take it? Because guess what happened? What happened was he burned it off. What happened was he starved off everything. He removed everything that I wanted to, like, that this was just like, I don't even know how to say it. this character defect, everything that fed into this, he took away. He took it away. And that was painful. So painful. But he took it all away so that I could burn this character defect off. And it's burned off. And now I'm walking and I'm operating from a place of freedom. And like, I can still carry this thing that like God has asked me to carry and nourish it well. Without this part of me, old me, that struggled. So whatever it is that is holding you back from carrying what the Lord has asked you to carry, like, go to God with it, because he wants to remove it and give you victory. Like he did for me, and it's so good.
Let me talk to you for a second. Hey, I'm Lori. So I just want to ask you this simple question. What do you see when you look at yourself? How do you speak to yourself internally? What is your internal dialogue that you're constantly saying in your own head? Are you saying things to yourself like, I'm not that pretty, I can never date that person, I can never be with this person, I can never have a situation like that, I could never drive that car, I could never live in that neighborhood, I can never have that job, I'm not this, I'm not that. If that sounds more like what your internal dialogue is, this message is for you. What I'm trying to get you to understand is all of those things that you're saying internally in your head are vows. You're literally making like vows to yourself that this is what you can't do. And the more you continue to speak those types of things to yourself, the more you continue to have that type of internal dialogue to yourself, you will continue to have those type of outcomes. Catch this. See, God cares not only about how we speak to other people, but he also cares about how we speak to ourselves and how we treat ourselves. It doesn't mean become haughty and high-minded and prideful. That's definitely not the case, but definitely not the opposite end either, which is just completely putting yourself down, belittling yourself, and bashing yourself. That's definitely not God either. What you need to do in this season is evaluate how you speak to yourself and the things that you're saying, the things that you're trying to tell yourself you can't do. I guarantee you a lot of the problems that you're dealing with and or facing in your life right now probably stem back to the way you are talking to yourself. If you didn't get that job, you probably somewhere in your head don't believe you can have it. If you didn't get into a relationship, somewhere in your mind you're thinking you don't deserve one. Do you even believe you deserve to be loved? Do you believe you deserve to be married? Do you believe you deserve to have love? So you need to check those things in this season of your life. Check the way you're thinking, the way you're speaking to yourself. And the second you find it, correct it. Repent of it and correct it. And come out of agreement with it by saying, you know what, that's not the truth. And I repent for the one that lie. And then come into the truth of who you really are. And as you begin to start to evaluate and assess those things, I guarantee you, your life and your situations are going to begin to change. You have those desires in your heart for a reason, because God put them there. We can't have you living in the world by telling yourself you can't have the very thing he says you can.
Hi, this is Prophetess Mildred. Do not quit. The devil knows which buttons of yours to push to cause you to throw in the towel. You are almost there. The manifestations of the promises of God for you and your family is around the corner. Come on, this is not the time for you to fight toe to toe with the devil. This is the time for you to put up a resistance against the enemy, and he will flee from you. The devil that come to steal, kill, and destroy, God is telling you to keep on keeping on. Come on, this is the time for you to push. Yes, I know it don't feel good. Yes, I know it's hard. I know it's difficult. But come on, keep pushing, because God has called you and has chosen you to be a generational curse breaker for your family. You have been called for such a time as this. Your family is depending on you to break every generational curse off of your bloodline. Come on, there is about to be a shift in your life. The generational curses that have been over your life for generations, my Lord, is about to be dismantled off of you and your family. You and your family are about to walk in that place, in that high place, in that promised place that God has for you and your family. You are almost there. Do not quit. It may feel lonely. You may be misunderstood, mishandled, mistreated, but do not quit. Stay in a posture of prayer. Send forth Judah. Send forth praises to God. Worship God. Trust in God and see the manifestation of your answered prayers, the manifestations of the blessings of God that is around the corner manifest in your life. Trust in God, for it will come to pass.
So many people ask me, you know, what made me believe in God? What made me give my life over to Him? Like, after all of the stuff I've been through, after all of the stuff they know I have done, said, who I used to be, like, how am I this person now? Well, it's simple. It's like, because God made me believe in Him. I was going to church ever since I was 5 years old, and you know, I was there. I grew up in the church. I was on the praise team. I did the praise dances. I was in skits. I talked to people. I was, you know, telling my testimony, all this, all the way up until age 19. But when I was finally able, well, when I got kicked out, I stopped going to church, you know. And that was probably around 2016. So I stopped going to church, started doing my own thing. I had my baby. I was just a mess. I was a mess. So from 2016 all the way up until 2021, I went through everything that you could think of. Like, the Lord literally was dragging me, but saving me at the same time, saving me from people and saving me from myself. So because He took me through so much but still spared my life, it gave me no choice but to believe in Him and to give my life back over to Him and to use my experiences to help other people not go through what I went through, because you really don't have to. Believing in God and knowing that God loves me created a heart of flesh within me, and it really allowed me to forgive people who did some of the worst things to me. But first, it allowed me to forgive myself for doing certain things and just placing myself in situations that I had no business. So, yeah, believing in God and really just focusing on Him now and not things of the world, and really being hungry for Him and going after Him and not being tired of seeking His face, no matter if I fall down, always getting back up, knowing that He's forgiven me and He's always with me. It's a lot to believe in. So, yeah, you just really gotta try and believe yourself, pretty much, and then you'll know what I'm talking about.
God said, I created you for perfection, something that I need of you. I created you to be able to withstand those battles, but knowing that I'm with you, love and of light. See, they thought they was going to destroy you, but all at the same time, they didn't know who was walking with you. They didn't know the army and of the legion of angels that was standing by you. So therefore, you must understand, like, look here, these battles and of these trials that I go through in my life to life is not to conquer me, but it's ever so more to make me greater in the process of my walking, of my step, of knowing who I am and what I stand for. See, God is a God of love, compassion, truth, honor. A lot of people is not going to honor truth, respect, love, but all at the same time, you knowing and understanding that every setback and of every trial only made you to be who you are right now as I speak to y'all, my brothers and sisters. See, I love my Father, truthfully, with all heart. I am not afraid to confess of who I serve in my walk. No, we're not perfect, but like I said before, we strive for perfection within. And God is like, you know what, son? You know what, daughter? I seen what you've been going through. And yes, the enemy did come to me, but see, I know what I instilled in you for you to overcome, for you to see the truth, for you to see what this world persuades upon you. as well as any type of circumstances or what was to make you fall. But you never did. You may have got discouraged at times. You may have had doubt at times. But you never let it broke you. And that's one thing you got to understand. That God is always with us. Always omnipresent amongst our trials. And when you understand that and you learn that and you know that, the way you walk is different. It's not like you walking on gravel no more. It's like you walking on clouds. And trust and truly believe me, the Heavenly Father created you. Self-gain. True honor. Perfection. So when people have issues and things with you, don't look at it as just so weary and ill that everybody's against you. They're supposed to be. But at the same time, do not let the inner beast of you let the enemy defeat you upon reckless actions. It's all truth and spoken and of God's blessings amongst y'all, my brothers and sisters. And it's all love and heart, especially of consideration. Walk the walk that y'all walking and keep stepping on them serpents' necks. Because like I said, they ain't got nothing for y'all. Y'all been destined for greatness. God bless.
Listen, I haven't been on here a while and I haven't been posting very much content. There's a reason. I've been away with the Lord. And trust me, there's no better feeling than being with just Him. But also, my family has COVID again. Go figure. But what could have been so bad turned out not so bad. And that's how God works. You see, sometimes He puts us on a sit down. Sometimes He puts us on a timeout. And that can come in many different ways. And sometimes we automatically want to blame the enemy. But understand, sometimes it's the Lord. Sometimes He's pausing us so we can actually seek Him more. He's putting on a sit down, you know, time away from work, kids out of school because they're sick. He's asking you to come be with Him, and He's giving you time to do so. There's a reason He's doing this more and more, especially with disciples. But what I love the most is He's on a constant search down and a constant chase down for sheep that went astray. I've been there. I know what that feels like. I know what it looks like. And to watch it is extremely beautiful. Yesterday, I had to go somewhere. Don't worry, stayed in my car. But as I was coming home, I looked up at the sky and I saw eyes. I saw literal eyes. I didn't have my phone and I was driving, or else I would have took a picture. But I could literally make out the eyelids, the bridge of the nose, eyelashes, and his eyeballs. And immediately, I couldn't keep my eyes off the sky and felt the Holy Spirit. I knew that it was God. He is constantly showing Himself. He is on a mission right now. He's letting us know that He's here. Look, I don't know about anybody else, but I want to stay prepared. I want to stay clung to Yahweh's hem of His garment, because I really feel that it could be any day, and I'm praising Him for it. But understand that if you're going through something right now, if you feel like, man, why am I sick? Why ain't this working out? Why did I have this promise and it didn't come to pass? Maybe it's still a promise. If He promises it to you, it's still a promise, but maybe not right now. Understand, He always finishes His promises with yes and amen. The Lord is slowing us down for a reason. And it's to take us deeper with Him. Are you ready? He's doing it on purpose because He loves us and He wants all of us with Him in heaven.